गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास एट, इट्स ग्रेट टू बी बैक एंड बी विथ यू अगेन. सो आई होप यू एंजॉयड योर लास्ट वीक एंड दिस वीक इज ऑल अबाउट इंडिपेंडेंस वीक. सो आई होप यू स्पेंड योर इंडिपेंडेंस वीक एट होम एंड सेफ. एंड वी आर इंडिपेंडेंट, वी आर फ्री, बट स्टिल इट्स लॉकडाउन. सो लेट्स सी व्हाट हैपेंस ऑन द 31st of August. And I pray that we all keep safe, and it's really great to know that you all are keeping safe and you are really taking good precautions of yourself. You know, I guess you are much more important than us to be safe. So children have to be safe, and I don't like children getting sick. So it's very pathetic, you know. I feel very bad. You know, whatever happens, let it happen to the people who are older, and children are supposed to be happy and safe and enjoy life. So that's what I also pray to God for all of you, all of the children all around the world. You know, children are very precious, and I'm so proud to have so many of them together, and that's all of you. So we'll be back to Sarojini Naidu's one nice poem. I have done another one poem just now with class 7. I did the Cradle Song, and it was a wonderful poem by Sarojini Naidu. And this is another wonderful one of the Coromandel Fishers by Sarojini Naidu. It's an awesome poem. You know, you have to understand, she was a freedom fighter. At the same time, she was writing about nature, about the feelings of people, how people struggle to survive. And just going into the sea for fishing or going to a river for fishing is quite dangerous. You know, you have to know swimming, you have to know the water currents, you have to know how to fish, you have to know how to throw a net, you have to know how to pick up the fish, you have to again to know how to tie the net. So I'll tell you a little story about a fisherman who go out in the sea. But before going into that, I want to explain some things about Sarojini Naidu. You know, because whenever you want to read something about a poem or whatever, you must know what this author is full about. Even if you know it's my, you must be knowing about Sarojini Naidu. We all know her as a freedom fighter, basically, but she's one of the most known, she was called the sobriquet of Nightingale of India. She was a child prodigy. Now, what's a prodigy, you will ask me? What did sir say these words? You know, we don't understand. Certainly, it's a prodigy. You must know what is prodigy first. Child prodigy. Prodigy is, how to explain it to you? How should I explain it? That's what I'm thinking. Like, she was a child prodigy means, research. A person who is under 10, who puts meaningful output, you know, in some domain to level of an adult. Child prodigy. Simply, that at the age of a child, you are psychologically developed and you are able to tackle an adult also. You think like an adult. You have that prodigy inside you. That is called child prodigy. You know, so talented at a very young age. You get talented at a very young age. A musical prodigy or a math prodigy. Mozart, the musician of the world's best musician, was once writing symphonies and playing for kings when he was only 5 years old. So you become a hero at the age, very young age. You try to master things at a very young age, you know. When you are equal to an adult, what an adult can't do, but you can do it. That's called a child prodigy. And another one is, I wanted to tell you, is She was named the Sorbiquit. Sorbiquit means nicknames. Like Pink City is Jaipur, Golden City of India is Jaisalmer, Steel City of India, Pittsburgh of India is Jamshedpur, or Perfume Capital of India is Kannauj, Uttar Pradesh. Okay, so Sorbiquit. So she was also given the nickname of the Nightingale of India. She was a child prodigy, Indian independence activist and poet. She was the first Indian woman to become the president of India, Indian National Congress, and also the first governor of a woman governor of a state of India, and that was Uttar Pradesh, Sarojini Naidu. She was a great patriot, his love for the country, politician, orator. She could speak very well, an administrator. That's why she was given this post. Of all the famous women of India, Mrs. Sarojini Devi Naidu's name is at the top. She is on top of the list. Not only that, but she was truly one of the jewels of the world, you can say. She was one of the most famous heroines of the 20th century. Her birthday is celebrated on Women's Day. Now you must be knowing the date of Women's Day. Do you or do you not? It's 13 February, Women's Day. And 14 February is Valentine's Day. What a coincidence. You spend more time during Valentine's Day, but you don't spend Women's Day. You should spend more time with your mom and sister and all for Women's Day. Women's Day also you spend with women also and girls also during Valentine. Otherwise, without a girl or a boy, you won't have Valentine, right? Anybody can be on Valentine. You have to just love that person. So, let's come back to Sarojini Naidu. She was born in Hyderabad. See, I have to discuss the author first, and after that we can go ahead and know what type of writing she does. Hyderabad, Sarojini Chattopadhyay. Later, Naidu belonged to a Bengali family of Kulin Brahmins. But her father, Aghorenath Chattopadhyay, after receiving a doctorate of science degree from Edinburgh University, settled down in Hyderabad state. And he founded the Hyderabad College and he administered that college, which later became the Nizam's College of Hyderabad. And again, Sarojini Naidu's mother, Baroda Sundari Devi, was also a poetess, Baji, and used to write poetry in Bengali. Sarojini Naidu was the eldest among the eight children. One of her brothers, Birendranath, was a revolutionary, and her other brother, Harindranath, was a poet, dramatist, and actor. So, all those are cultured family. Generation, cultured generation, you will have good people only. She was a brilliant student. She was proficient in Urdu, Telugu, English, Bengali, and Persian. At the age of 12, Sarojini Naidu attained the national fame when she topped the matriculation exam at Madras University. It is class 9-10. At the age of 12, child prodigy. Her father wanted her to become a mathematician or scientist, but Sarojini Naidu was interested in poetry. Once she was working on an algebra problem, and when she couldn't find the solution, she decided to take a break. And she came back to the book. And she wrote an inspired poet. She wrote her first inspired poetry. She got so enthused by this that she wrote The Lady of the Lake. 1300 lines long. When her father saw that she was more interested in poetry than mathematics or science, he decided to encourage her. With her father's support, she wrote the play Maher Munir in the Persian language. Dr. Chattopadhyay distributed some copies among his friends and sent one copy to the Nawab of Hyderabad. Reading a beautiful play written by a young girl, the Nizam was very impressed. The college gave her a scholarship to study abroad. At the age of 16, she got admitted to the King's College, England. Imagine. She travelled to England at the age of 16 to the King's College, London, and later at Girton College, Cambridge. There she met famous little laureates of her time, such as Arthur Symons and Edmund Gosse. It was Gosse who convinced Sarojini Naidu ji to stick to Indian themes about India, write about them, great mountains, rivers, temples, social milieu, to express her poetry. She depicted contemporary Indian life and events. Her collections were The Golden Threshold 1905, The Bird of Time 1912, and The Broken Wing 1912 attracted huge Indian and English readership. People started reading her. Imagine. It's good to know about someone, you know. Then she, while staying in England, she fell in love with a person called Mr. Dr. Govinda Rajulu Naidu. He was a non-Brahmin and a doctor by profession, and fell in love with him. But after finishing her studies at the age of 19, she got married to him during the time when inter-caste marriage was not allowed. But her father was a very open-minded person. He did not care what people others said. He said, my daughter is happy, everyone is happy. So marriage was a very happy thing. They were Kulin Brahmins and he was a non-Brahmin, doctor by profession. But her work contributed and made her top. Her major contribution was in the field of poetry. Her poetry had beautiful words that could be sung. Soon she got recognition as the Bulbul-e-Hind, when her collection of poems were published in 1905 under the title Golden Threshold. After that, she published The Bird of Time, The Broken Wings, Feast of Youth, later The Magic Tree, The Wizard Mask, A Treasury of Poems were also published. Maharshi Arvind, Rabindranath Tagore and Jawaharlal Nehru were among the thousands of admirers of her work. Her poems had English words but an Indian soul. One day she met Sri Gopal Krishna Gokhale. Okay, I'll come back in the next video.